My e-bike is faster than ever, and in this video I'll show you how you can do it too. In the last episode we installed this programmable controller, and now we're gonna push this tiny motor to its limits. This is our electric motor, commonly used in electric vehicles like e-bikes and scooters. If these motors run at the power they were intended to, then they would last a very long time. But what happens when you run them above their usual limits? Heat. This heat leads to shorter lifespan and reduced efficiency of the motor. Luckily, you can manage this heat in several ways, but of course, we want more power. So heat we must manage. One of the best solutions for this is ferromagnetic fluid, or statorade. This type of motor is a BLDC, brushless direct current motor, and uses permanent magnets. The copper windings sit very close to these magnets, and when current flows through the wires, it creates a magnetic field. Basically, what happens when we turn the throttle is that the controller sends current through the correct wires or phases of the motor in order to create a magnetic field in the wires that opposes or attracts to the magnets. The stronger the current, the stronger the magnetic field and also the torque of the motor. The heat comes from the wires. Since they aren't perfect, they have some resistance. When you push a nominal amount of current through them, there's almost no heat generated. But when we push more current, the wires heat up. Up until 100 degrees C, there is no issue for the motors, but above 140 degrees C, the damage starts. This statorade is attracted by magnetic fields, so it will sit around the magnets of the motor and will close in the gap between the windings and the magnets, basically improving the thermal conductivity of the stator to the rotor and the outside aluminum casing. First step is to open up the motor, but be aware that some motors already have a hole for adding ferrofluid, sometimes in one of the disc brake holes. In my case, I am opening the motor to add this one temperature sensor and also to hopefully waterproof the motor. You just need to remove one of the side covers if you are only adding the fluid, but since you're there, might as well waterproof the motor a little more. When we had this inside the motor, we get a bit of drag from the fluid sloshing inside, but the heat generated inside the motor gets out quicker. At the maximum speed, the stock motor can overheat, while with statorade, the motor should be able to run forever. Hopefully next time I'll have some real data to show how the ferrofluid acts with our new e-bike. We just need to add the correct amount of ferrofluid to the motor, and this will depend on the size of the motor. So in our case, with an MX's 3K, we're gonna use 5 to 6 milliliters of this ferrofluid. Now we just need to go in the reverse order and close the side cover. If you removed both covers like me, it'll be very tricky to fit the core inside the magnets and also make it spin without a wobble, so be careful. Add a bead of gasket sealant so no water or condensation gets in. Before tightening all the screws, just put the motor on a fork and watch it spin. Try to center it as best as you can. All the upgrades are done. All there's left to do is test drive. Stay tuned and subscribe for the next episode.